An incident, an accident-packed night marked the opening of the Speedway season at the Express Printing House, Ruapuna Speedway. The crash and ambulance crews did overtime, but that aside, there were still some solid performances. In the feature races, Alex Borum held out Cromwell's Lyndon Buchanan and the fast-finishing James Thyon to lock up the youth mini stocks, while Tom Lumsden picked up where he left off from last season, dominating the modified sprint feature event. Numerous accidents in the early midget races saw just five survivors for their feature. Dave Kerr and Andrew Brown from Nelson had a great battle, with Kerr managing to hold out Brown, while ex-sidecar racer Bryce McCall got up into third slot. Glenn Everett snuck down low early in the race to get his nose in front for the sprint car feature, and there he stayed, while an intriguing battle between Ryan Stone and Glenn Jury in the TQs resulted in Stone notching up yet another feature win. This week, the Express Printing House feature race of the week came from the midgets.
For a start, are we going to get it this time? Well, we did, although slightly out of line, but it's number 11, Bryce McCall, that gets away to a pretty clean start, although went up to just a bit too high there and lost it, putting the power on though and looking to get around the outside and claim the lead back as they come out of turn four. We'll pick them up as they come into the front straight. It's 11 down by the wall and 57, and that's of course Andrew Brown from Nelson in that second position, but all sorts of changes going on now, and it's all happening. Only five cars, but obviously a bit of quality in amongst it as they head around out of turn four once again. Let's see who's got the lead this time. And it is Dave Kerr, and of course no surprises there, even though he was from position number four on the starting order. It doesn't take him long to get around the pack. Had a great season last season, looking to carry on his winning way this season. So it's 99 Dave Kerr that's got the lead now. Then we go back to Andrew Brown and Bryce McCall in second and third respectively, and heading on down the back straight again. The laps will count down pretty quickly, given that we only had eight to start with. 99 Dave Kerr it is, out of turn four again, and another lap to go down. These guys have picked their lines pretty well, and not much happening else. Bryce McCall nearly got it sideways, managed to correct just in time. Lost a bit of ground though as they head on down the back straight into Prison Bend once again, and it is still number 99 Dave Kerr out in front. Andrew Brown not giving it away. Bryce McCall there next. Then we go back to 19 Gary Robertson and 21 Gavin Wilkie, all the way up from Dunedin, just tailing out a bit at the back of the field at the moment. Meanwhile, up front, things are still pretty hot between number 99 Dave Kerr and 57 Andrew Brown. In fact, they're side by side, and there's 57 Andrew Brown down on the inner. Dave Kerr takes the high line. Andrew Brown comes out of it the better as they head on down the back, but the power comes on from Dave Kerr in the 99 car, and he's grabbed the lead back as they come out of turn four. We'll get the white flag this time. Last lap now for 99 Dave Kerr, 57 Andrew Brown. Can he have one more lunge to get that lead back? Lost a bit of ground that time. 99 Dave Kerr puts the hammer down, heads on down the back straight into Prison Bend, through the apex, out of turn four, looking towards the checkered. Let's see who we've got. We've got 99 Dave Kerr, 57 Andrew Brown is next, and just number 11 Bryce McCall just about went across start finish sideways. So that was a pretty exciting finish too. But 99, 57 and 11, your official 1-2-3.